summer night in the Rocky Mountains, the show comes to you from Coors Field in downtown Denver. Tonight, the second of three to start the week between the Pittsburgh Pirates and the Colorado Rockies. Major League Baseball on the show is next. Ryan Yarbrough, a left-handed Floridian, will get the starting assignment. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, you take a look at that ERA, and it's a little bloated right now. This guy's a better pitcher than that, but he hasn't been real consistent. One good game, one bad game. I think what he needs to do, if he can string together three or four good quality games in a row, that ERA will start creeping back down. He definitely needs to start pitching a lot better than he has up to this point, and it'll be interesting to see if he can turn it around in this one.
Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1.
First pitch, 640.
Sliced hard on the ground. Throw to first is in time for the first down. A chance here to check out the starting lineup for the visiting Pirates. Dan, who do we keep an eye on?
Well, they're looking for a little better right now out of Andrew Vaughn. Over the last 10 games, he's only hit one home run, and as a guy that hits in the middle order, they're expecting a lot more from him than just one bomb. The power just hasn't been there over this stretch.
Andrew Vaughn, the next to bat, and he enters play today, currently fifth in the National League batting race.
What a terrific season this guy's having. Up near the leaders in batting average, without a doubt the highest average and the best hitter on this team.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Hit hard down the line. McMahon gathers it in. Throw gets him. Two down. Now at the plate here is Brian Reynolds, as the switch hitter will bat right-handed here.
Definitely not the side where he hits for more thunder. More pop in the bat swinging left-handed, but he's going to have to figure out a way to start to get a little bit more thunder swinging right-handed against left-handed pitching.
Ball one to start the at-bat. Now, boys, we take a look at the Rockies' starting play here tonight. Now, they've been on a pretty good roll of late, winners of seven of their last eight ball games.
Yeah, Matty B. Hey, D-Row, we're looking at a team that's playing some pretty good baseball right now. Through the first five games of this homestand, 4-1, and looking for some bigger and better things.
Yeah, we had a chance to sit down before the game after BP with the manager. He was...
And the throw is in time to get him to retire the side. Down in order go the Pirates. And now the Rockies will go on offense for the first time. No score. Carlos Martinez, a right-handed native of the Dominican Republic, will be the starter. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Well, Matt, you're not always sure what you're going to get from Carlos Martinez. Guy has a big arm, throws in the mid to upper 90s, good assortment of off-speed pitches. He's been very inconsistent throughout his career. He's tried the bullpen. They've moved him into the starting rotation. The key for Martinez, throwing strikes. If he throws strikes, he has a chance to shut somebody down.
So now into the box is Garrett Hampson. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Runs up and gets this one down. And he will not have a play behind him. It's an infield single.
That's shortstop.
Brendan Rodgers bats next. As you get a look at his current righty-lefty splits entering play in this one. Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Ball, that's in.
And he just misses inside with the fastball there. D-Row, Dan, we look at this Pirates ball club as they enter play here tonight. They come in trying to bounce back from a loss last time out, but they've been in good form lately, 5-2 over their last seven.
Yeah, Matty V, and you know what, D-Row? Now I guess it's time where you push that go button. You're getting a little sense of urgency. They find themselves in third place, and if they want to be part of the postseason picture, it's time to get going and get going pronto.
Yeah, it's taken too long for this team to carve out any identity for themselves. They're going to have to find a way to get on a roll.
Offensively, pitch wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
Now a move over to first, and he'll get back in standing. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Well, his struggles continue. It's been a rough go of it at the plate with him.
And
watching this at bat, it's clear to me that his rhythm and timing, they're just all off. Even as a pitcher like I was, you can tell these things and exploit them.
Now a throw over to first and a dive, but he's back in. Standing in now, number nine, as he will take a fastball in there at the knees for strike one. First chance for him here with a runner at first and one gone.
We're seeing a good AB here from the three-hole hitter. If he can work a walk or pick up a hit here, he's going to put that cleanup guy in a really good position to do some damage in this first inning.
And he lays off here. Nice job. It's ball four. First and second now with one away.
Batting fourth, the first baseman.
Digging in next will be Chris Bryant. No career at-bats for him against this particular arm in the past. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Strike three called, and now he's one out away from getting out of this.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. When you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
Here's Ryan McMahon now. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He'll start this one at 274. Four home runs and 22 RBI. Ready with the 1-2. Hard hit ball to second. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. The throw to the plate. The tag, and he is out at the plate. So much for our first run of the ball game. Two left for Colorado. This is still a nothing-nothing ball game. So here's Michael Chavis now, and the home away splits tell us he's actually quite a bit better hitting on the road than he is at home. In there, a called strike three. Next up, Kevin Newman. First shot for him here. Two hits in five trips a night ago. The pitch. Line to the right side. But taken in over at first for the second out, as that might have been extra bases if it were 3 feet higher. Next up is Travis Darnot. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. No score here as we play inning number two. hit in the air down the right field line. Right fielder is on the run. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Pirates. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Striding in for the Rockies, Elias Diaz. Set to lead off the home half of the second.
Put away stuff.
The next 0-2. Offered at and missed. He chased it for strike three.
Made pretty quick work of him right there, setting him down on only four pitches. And what I liked about all of those pitches, when they were down around the knees or lower. Pretty hard to do any kind of damage when pitches are located in that spot.
So now to the plate, Chaz McCormick. And a ball 1-0. The numbers on the year, 272. 9 homers, 26 RBI. This is on the ground over to first. Fielded cleanly, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
Batting it, the right fielder, Randall Grichuk.
Here's Randall Grichuk. He has no prior history against this pitcher. Here's the first pitch. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Below the zone, a swing and a miss. A bouncer to the left side. He's got it. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Rockies. We'll move to the third with no score. Now to the plate, here is Ryan McBroom. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
The pitch.
Ball one. Count 1-0.
Ball number 3. Key Brian Hayes, the number 8 hitter here, waits on deck. Oh, that should have been ball 4 there, but it's a called strike, and that runs things full at 3-2. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. But this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Another full count pitch home. Boy, good cutting action to that pitch as that's the first out of the inning. Key Brian Hayes digging in now. First chance for him here after appearing as a pinch hitter in the game last night. Now here it comes. A bouncer up the middle, reined in. And there are 2 away now.
And this is not an easy play when you have to range to your right. He really didn't have a chance to get his feet set, so this is all arm. Nicely done.
To the plate now, Carlos Martinez. As he'll look at a breaking ball that misses for ball 1. His guy's still looking at a 0 in the hit column. The 1-0 is Davis swung on and missed strike one.
The count, one and one.
You have to find a way to lay off that low sinker. There is just no way to do any damage. You're just looking at either a bruised shin or a ground out to the left side.
This one's flared down the right field line. And the Pirates are in the hit column.
Boy, Dewar, you're talking about frustrating as a pitcher. You have the pitcher up with two outs, and he extends the inning there with a base hit.
Yeah, it's funny. I've hit eighth in my career, and the grind was to try and get the pitcher up so you could waste that out and flip the lineup over. This guy took it into his own hands and did just that. By getting a knock, now we could have some issues here.
One ball, no strikes, the count. The inside part of the plate. Martinez, the runner at first with two gone. Hit weakly back to the mound. Throw in time and the side is retired. One hit, one left. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. And we are tied 0-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And that'll bring up the pitcher, Ryan Yarbrough. Here's the first pitch. In there for strike one. A 1-2. Swing and a ground ball to third. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
The batter, number one.
Next to hit, Garrett Hampson. Third baseman in tight, protecting the bunt, the first pitch. Bottom of inning number three, 0-0 our score. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Chavis is moving forward. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. Digging in will be Brendan Rodgers. He went down on strikes in his last at bat. Another payoff pitch. Pulls this one in the air out to left. Vaughn will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Three up, three down for Colorado. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless.
There's a strange wind blowing. It's coming back.
And stepping in, Andrew Vaughn. He bats here as the reigning rookie of the month in the National League.
I know we're not seeing a lot of offense in this one, but there's still some game left. I'm looking to see these guys, both offenses, make some notable adjustments at the dish and try and scratch a few runs across.
But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first down.
Jumped all over that first pitch of the inning, and he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
So now it's Brian Reynolds. As he'll take a look at a sinker here, too low for ball one. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Into his windup, here comes the 1-0. This one's down to third. Oh, beautiful dive. It's there, and he's out.
That ball almost got through the hole right there. Could have been a seeing eye single. Love to step in a dive to his left. That's actually a harder play. It's almost easier to go backhand when you're reacting at third base. Nice play right there. Nice angle to the baseball.
Into the box, Michael Chavis. And he fouls this one off. 0-for-1 for him. The 2-2. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. And the inning will continue as that's through for a two-out hit.
Hey,
after that hit right there, Dero, that extends his hitting streak to 6 games.
Yeah, no doubt about it. 6 days in a row with knocks will help you sleep better at night, Dan.
In now, Kevin Newman. As he'll get out ahead of a changeup and swing through it for strike one. Hit it hard, but lined out in his first at bat. Both teams with just 2 hits apiece thus far. Hit in the air to center field. He's under it, and that ends the inning. Pirates leave one. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. And now, number 9 is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Number 9.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch.
Hey. 0-1 to the count.
Sent on the ground out to second. Newman brings it in, and that's the first down.
Now back, first baseman. Brian.
Next, it'll be Chris Bryant. 0-for-1, went down looking his first time up.
Yeah, always frustrating to go down looking. Everybody does it, though. You'll have a few ABs.
It's cut on and missed for strike two.
Hey, he's got great feel for that pitch right there. He can throw it anytime he wants for a strike.
Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And they'll get the ball back in quickly, holding him to a single.
The third baseman, number 24, Ryan.
At the plate, Ryan McMahon, as the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one.
Man, he's looking sharp so far. 80% of his first pitches are for strikes.
The next 3-2. It's the top of the zone. He struck him out looking.
Runner on first in a double play situation, so you expect to see a lot of pitches down in the zone. So I think that pitch up right there was a good one. Obviously, the double play is more efficient, but you're always going to take a K when you're on the mound.
Elias Diaz the next to hit, as he'll take a changeup here for strike one. Struck out in his first at bat. Bryant leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. High fly ball out to straightaway center. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Rockies strand one through four. Still tied, nothing, nothing. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Matt, I had a chance to catch up with manager Derek Shelton during the commercial break about the Pirates' offense. And one thing he mentioned to me was the lack of discipline he's seeing out of their at-bats right now. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, thanks, Heidi. All ready to go in the top of the fifth. And up next, the catcher, Travis Darno. Here it's 1-2. Hit on the ground out to short. Rogers picks it up. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Now batting, the first baseman, Ryan McBroom.
So stepping in is Ryan McBroom, comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Now the first pitch. Cut fastball taken for strike one. in front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Looking to punch him out again. The pitch. Swing and a liner. And that's into the outfield for a one out hit. Around first, digging for two. And he'll reach second now with one away.
I'll tell you, that's one of the first good swings we've seen anybody put on this guy so far. He's been throwing the ball really well, but that was one of the few mistakes we've seen him make.
Into the box now, Hayes, as he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate.
Well, what do you do when guys keep fouling pitches off like this? I guess you could back them off the plate by throwing one inside.
And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Good pitch there. That was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
At the plate now, Carlos Martinez, as he swings and grounds it toward the hole. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. One left for Pittsburgh. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Watney.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Rockies skipper Bud Black between innings, specifically about his club's offensive output to this point. And flat out, he was very pleased with the quality of their at-bats. Despite the fact that they've yet to push a run across, the game is still tied, and the pitch count for their opposition is really getting up there. They think that making him work as hard as he has is going to pay off later in the game, and that they just need to stick to the process.
All right, Heidi, thank you.
Leading off for the Rockies.
Bottom of the inning now. And he gets him to pop it up on the right side of the infield. And this is taken in for out number one.
The right fielder, number 15, Randall Bridget.
Now with the plate is Randall Bridget, grounded out in his last at bat. First pitch on its way. First, and very quickly, two are gone in the home fifth.
The pitcher, number 50, Ryan Yarbrough.
Now at the plate, Ryan Yarbrough. He bounced out last time up. First pitch on the way. Clips the corner of the zone with a sinker for a strike.
Hey, this guy's got to be pretty proud of what he's done so far. It's never
his hands in a 1-2 count.
Man, the pitcher let the guy off easy right there. That 0-2 pitch wasn't even close. I'd rate that as a non-competitive pitch.
Here comes the 1-2. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Nothing across here this half. We're through five here at the ballpark, and we still have no score. All set for the start of the inning, and coming forward now is the shortstop, O'Neill Cruz. Now the first pitch. Now the bunt attempt hits him here, but they're going to say he offered at it, and that's the first strike. Barely able to make contact, down 0-2 now. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. And he popped him up over toward the left side of the infield. And there's out number one.
Now back, left fielder, Andrew Vaughn.
At the plate now is Andrew Vaughn. He's grounded out and lined out in two trips. And the pitch. Swing and a miss at a first pitch changeup. Nothing in one. Bases are empty. One man out. Out in front as he grounds this one to short. In time to first, and there are two away.
The center fielder, number 10, Brian Reynolds.
And now in the box, Brian Reynolds. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point. First pitch on its way. There's the cut fastball, but it's low, 1-0.
Hey, this one's tied late in the game.
Hit hard on the ground to first. And that is through into right field for a single.
The right fielder, number 31, Michael Chavis.
To the plate now, Michael Chavis. So take a look at ball one. A hit and two at bats for him at this point in the ball game. Ready with the 1-0 pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
Reynolds is off a first with two away. There's a swing and a high drive into left center field. Back on it is the left fielder at the track. A leap, but it's off his glove. Chavis makes the turn at third. He wants it all. And he's safe at the plate as it's now a 2-0 ball game. So now to the plate, Kevin Newman. As the first pitch to him is a changeup that can't find the zone. It's ball one. He's 0-for-2 in the ballgame so far. It up 1-1. Now here's the pitch to third. McMahon's got it. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. Top of the order due up in the home half of the sixth. It's the Pirates 2 and the Rockies nothing.
For the Rockies, the second baseman, number one.
First pitch of the AB on its way. As he takes a cold strike at the knees, it's 0-1.
Pitcher wants to have a quick inning right here, capitalize on the momentum his batters have.
Lifted in the air toward the line and right. Right fielder giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And with that, we give you a look here at what's happening in the race in the National League Central. So the next to bat will be Brendan Rodgers, 0-for-2 on his line thus far. Now here's the first offering. swing and he pops him up. Chavis is moving forward, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
Dan, that can't bother you too much as a pitcher. Guys swinging first pitch.
Now, one of the things you want to do, D-Rose, you have to try to get ahead with the first pitch. You want to throw one of the first two pitches for strikes. Unfortunately, sometimes when you bring the ball in the strike zone, you're bound to give up some base hits, but hopefully he can minimize the damage here.
Now here's the Pirates manager up out of the dugout on his way to the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. So as he departs, he'll remain responsible for the man left to board, but he cannot lose this one. Heath Hembry enters to make an appearance on the mound as he inherits a runner at first with one out in the inning. In now, number nine. As he will take strike one on the fastball here, no balls and a strike. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. There's a shin-high slider laid off for a ball.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
And he'll dive back in. A ball and two strikes now.
That's the exact spot to lean on as a reliever. As a hitter, you just have to tip your cap and look for the next one.
Ready on one and two. Misses ball two.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
Grounded up the first baseline. He'll go to the bag for one, and it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw.
Great diving stop down there at first to get the out. If that ball gets to the outfield, the whole complexion of this inning drastically changes.
Here's Chris Bryant now, as he can't catch up on a fastball at the letters, and it's strike one. One for two in the ball game.
Roll over something.
One ball and two strikes to count. Working on hanging another zero, the pitch. Got him swinging. Made him chase outside the zone that time, and that puts an end to the inning. One left for Colorado. They trail it here 2-0. Carlos Estevez is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven. Ready now is Travis d'Arnaud. His career numbers against this pitcher, he's 1-for-5. First offering on its way. On the season, d'Arnaud brings a batting line of barely over 200, so there's certainly some room for improvement there.
He'd be the first to tell you he's not happy with his batting average this season, but he can beat you in a variety of different ways, and he has to because he wouldn't be here otherwise.
And there's a line drive, base hit to left field.
Kind of interesting pitch selection right there. You could tell you double up on the changeup normally when you got a guy out front on his front side. Not the case right here. He spit on that first changeup take right there, so I was shocked he went to the well again.
So next to bat will be Ryan McBroom. He doubled his last time through.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Bobby Bradley will come on to pinch hit now with a runner at first and nobody out.
Number 44, Bobby Bradley.
From the belt, the pitch, as he'll get caught chasing a bad one there. It's tried out.
Might have to change your game plan in the box right here. If he's going to pound away, might have to work the opposite field.
Fastball swung on and missed for the first down.
Oh man, he's been absolutely getting overmatched at the plate the last couple of games. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone. So clearly this pitching staff, they figured out how to attack this guy. We'll see if he can make any adjustments.
Standing in now, Key Brian Hayes. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. Chopped now to short. Can they get two? And that's the second out. Canaan Smith will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 24, Canaan Smith.
First pitch on the way. But a good play by the first baseman to spear this one, and that'll retire the side. Pirates leave one as they're unable to add to their 2-0 lead. Bobby Bradley stays in the ballgame after pinch hitting as he'll take over at first base.
Now playing first base, number 44, Bobby Bradley.
Anthony Banda is going to come on in relief as he'll be making his 20th appearance of the season. Last half of the seventh here. Ryan McMahon digs in to bat next.
Ryan McMahon.
Here's the first pitch. Swing, and there it goes. He got all of this one. And that ball will stay fair, and it's gone. A home run. Solo shot down the line in right. Home run number 5 on the year. And the Rockies have made this a 2-1 ball game.
What a great feeling right there as he circles the pillows. Finally able to get this offense potentially going with one swing of the bat. Being shut out all game, but not anymore.
Into the box, Elias Diaz. As he takes the fastball in there at the knees for strike one. 0-for-2 for him to this point. And the pitch.
1-1.
Hit hard back up the middle. A dive and he knocks it down. And no chance at a recovery here as despite a great effort that time, they won't get it out on the play.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan.
You know, deal on a spot like that. That's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Fouled off. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Working for the punch out and the offering. Curveball got him swinging for the first out.
Boy, he's having a hard time just putting the ball in play right now. He took the hat trick with three strikeouts yesterday, and here's another one today. Looks to me like he just needs to simplify his approach and focus on making some contact.
Now time is called, and the reliever is warm out there. Is Merrill Petit takes the mound now, and it appears he's being brought in to face the right-handed batter who waits next.
Yeah, you usually don't hear the term righty specialist very often, but that's kind of how they're using him here, Matt. Most hitters have a harder time against pitchers of the same handedness, so we'll see if this move pans out.
Randall Grichuk at the plate now. Grounded back up the middle. The second for one. On to first, and how about that for an entrance? One pitch, two outs, and the inning is over. But the Rocks draw a bit closer thanks to the solo home run. Seven complete here tonight. It's the Pirates 2 and the Rockies 1. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Austin Davis will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jameson Hanna is into the ball game as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. From the stretch, as he swings and misses at a first pitch fastball, behind nothing and two. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
People always talk about how important getting the leadoff men on base is, and it's true. So in the eighth inning of a one-run game, that's a really nice job of attacking a hitter and sending him packing.
Stepping in now, Andrew Vaughn.
Outside,
as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Ball three.
Looked like he tried to elevate a fastball on that 2-2 pitch there, but kind of overdid it. With a pitch that high, it's pretty easy to lay off if you're the hitter.
Oh, and he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
At the plate now, Brian Reynolds. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this. And he pumps the fastball by him here, one and two now.
Hey, this could be a huge momentum swing for this team right here. Relief pitcher has come busting through the gates and done his job. Try and get this team back in the dugout where the offense can get rolling.
And a reach, but he can't get there as it falls.
Dan, right here you see a situation where no doubles defense comes back to bite you. As a pitcher, were you even aware when guys are playing a foot off the track?
I'll be honest with you, D-Row. You're so concerned about it on the mound trying to get that white ball to that dark brown or black glove that I never really ever turned around to even know it's where they were playing. I was concerned about getting the guy out swinging the bat.
He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. Good curveball there, gets the swing and miss.
Put that in the memory bank. First time he breaks out a curveball right there, and it's a pretty good one.
Looking for the strikeout, here's the 0-2 pitch. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Hanna finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. One left for Pittsburgh. They still lead it 2-1. So now to the plate, Jameson Hanna, and he's getting his first plate appearance here in the eighth after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. And a good pitch on the inside corner for strike one.
Now that's just a nasty cutter right there. I don't care if that's his cold zone, he doesn't handle that pitch in that well. Most hitters don't get to that.
Oh, and two, here it comes. ground ball sent back up the middle. And that is Byam on into center field. So good hitting on 0-2 nets him a leadoff single.
The leadoff hitter finds his way on base. Should be interesting to see the cat and mouse with the manager. Does he use the bunt right here? Do we put a little hit and run on? Do we go old school, new school, and just let him swing away? Should be interesting.
Quick check on that time run at first. Just keeping him close. And that'll bring in Garrett Hampson. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. On to first, but it's too late as the first base umpire says they just missed getting him at the bag. Striding in is Brendan Rodgers trying here to plate the tying run from second. He's set and the pitch. Bunt attempt, but this one might have too much on it. Throw on to first, so the sacrifice is successful.
Now
you can't ask for anything more than that. The tying run moves over to third now with only one out, so we'll see how the infield decides to play it here.
Next, here is number 9. He comes in 0-2 thus far. And it looks as though the decision makers in the dugout will give him a free pass to first, so the bases are loaded here on the intentional walk, and the force play is now in order.
That's what's called getting the treatment. Everyone knows he's a power threat with the bat, so it's all about not letting him be the guy that beats you.
Time is called and the reliever is warm out there. Richard Rodriguez was called upon to pitch, really needing that double play ball. Bases are loaded here with only one man out. First pitch of the AB on its way. Chris Bryant comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Boy, the Rockies have been looking for that big hit all game long. They haven't been able to come through so far, but now would be the time to come through.
And boy, was he ever fooled on that pitch. It's 0-2 now.
Hey, don't kid yourself. I know those were two bad swings, but he hits middle of the order for a reason. It only takes one swing.
And now he'll foul this one off as well to fall behind here. No balls and two strikes.
If you're on the mound right there and you're getting a swing at a breaking ball off the plate, do not be shocked if he's tucked something up under this guy's chin right here.
To 1-2 now. One out with the possible tying and go-ahead runs on base here. Oh, and a comebacker. This could be big. There's one on to first. And talk about doing the job out of the bullpen. One batter, two outs, and the inning is over. Just what the doctor ordered. He gets the double play to get him out of the inning. Back with more here on a Tuesday night after this. Scott Oberg enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. New inning set to get underway, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Kevin Newman. He's ready. Here's the first pitch. Hard hit ball towards the hole, and he'll break through with a solid knock here, his first of the ball game. With that, the Buccos have their leadoff man aboard to kick off the inning. So he waited till the ninth inning, but he comes through here to extend the hit streak. That was close.
Yeah, Matty B, you see that wry smile of him coming out of the box right there? He knew what was on the line. He'd be lying if he didn't.
There's a lot of pressure on you because you're walking into that batter's box thinking, I have a nice streak going, and this is more than likely going to be my last AB. He comes through in the clutch.
Travis d'Arnone stands in as he can't connect here. 0-1. Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
talk about blowing it by a guy. Geez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
So now to the plate, Bobby Bradley, as he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. Looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat. The 2-0 on the way. This is popped up. Rogers calls for it. And he brings it in for the second out of the inning.
The third baseman, number 13, T. Brian Hay.
So it's a runner at first with two men out. And up next is Key Brian Hayes. He's set. Here it comes.
Ball.
You know, because this is just a one-run game.
And the at-bat will continue. One-run game here in the top of the ninth. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away. Blake Sable will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Pinch hitting for Pittsburgh. Number 35, Blake Sable.
Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. He's got that batting average even at a point where even a 1-for-5 will gain him some points. Two home runs and seven driven in. Big swing and a miss at the fastball. He's behind in the count 0-2.
Sometimes guys get a little less aggressive pitching with a couple of runners on base, but not here. That was two good fastballs to take control of the bat.
And we'll just leave it there as they make the play. David Bednar is the man called on to close this one and earn a save in the ninth.
Number 51, David Bednar.
So now here is Ryan McMahon. He'll lead things off here in this one-run contest.
Most good breaking ball hitters will hit good breaking balls. And that last at-bat, that was a pretty good pitch that was down in the zone. And he handled it really nice.
Now the 1-0. Bouncer up the middle. Throw just in time, and oh, that was awfully close.
Now the catcher. Oh, Diaz.
Stepping in next, Elias Diaz. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. First delivery to him. Skied in the air to straightaway left. Left fielder is on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Now batting, the pitcher, Scott Homerun.
Christian Vasquez will pinch hit here, and he's the potential tying run. And now the first pitch. As he'll take a called strike at the knees, it's 0-1. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Good pitch as this is swung on and missed. And now they're down to perhaps their final strike of the evening.
Hey, down in the count 0-2, I'd like to see a little choke and poke right here. Maybe work it up the middle or opposite.
Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Well, it's getting more and more common in baseball now these days to use a ton of pitchers to get through a game, and it took 6 here to get the job done, but hey, they'll do whatever they can to get a W.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. Pittsburgh rode an important 6th inning to victory in this one. Carlos Martinez with his 4th win this season. Ryan Yarbrough pitched well, allowing only 2 earned, but ends up taking the loss. David Bednar records the save, his 16th of the season. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com. Services, not a holy man, but a moral in my
don't love me. I'm guessing I'ma be okay. You say that you don't feel me now. I feel like I'ma live somehow. But love never meant much to me. Love never meant much to me. Your love never.
Here now is our final line score tonight. For the victorious Pirates, 2 runs on 8 hits, no errors. They left 7 men on base. For the Rockies, 1 run, 8 hits, no errors.